We're going to be going over body condition scoring of beef cattle, which is a very important practice that pretty much anyone who owns a beef animal from 1 to 100 really ought to be in control of in their herd and be able to evaluate their animals. It's something that throughout the year is going to fluctuate, and it can fluctuate for a lot of reasons. It can fluctuate for feed, what type of feed they're on, or availability of feed. It can fluctuate due to their age, so younger animals, growing animals, beef animals, mother cows, older cows, breeding heifers. There's a lot of different stages throughout their life that body condition is going to change and be very important. It varies from 1 to 9, and it's very easy. 1 is going to be something that's skinny or emaciated and kind of just all skin and bones, versus something that's 9, which you can imagine is going to be very overweight and really obese. And kind of like everything in life, you know, you don't want too little and you don't want too much. So you don't really want to be at either of those extremes for different reasons. Bad body condition scores can actually cause problems. And so me as a veterinarian, there's a lot of things that I do to help sick animals that oftentimes are induced by different body condition scores of animals being too heavy, having problems having their calf, or being too heavy and getting injured, or being too thin and not being able to get pregnant, or being too thin and getting hypothermic, or something else that happens. So you guys can kind of get an idea that body condition is really an important thing. So the areas that we like to feel on a beef cow for body condition score: the fat area over their ribs, and then moving into their flank area, the ends of the short ribs, we like to try to palpate them underneath the fat cover from their hooks to their pins and their pelvis, from right here to right here. And then also the amount of fat between their pelvis and their tail, right here. Body condition is going to vary between different breeds, and you can even kind of see that at UConn here of animals that are managed the same and they're fed the same and they're on the same annual cycle. They're going to have a little bit differences just due to their genetic background. So this is a Angus, or predominantly Angus, cow. She's on the smaller frame size. In her, it's very obvious, is instead of having a nice rounded top line here, we have kind of almost more of a concave shape to her. These are called the paxial muscles. This is where a lot of the good steaks come from in beef animals. So if you were looking at an animal that you were going to process and make beef out of, she's not an ideal point. Her steaks would not taste very good at all. There's not going to be very much fat there. If I had to grade her, I would probably put her probably in a 4 to a 5. She's a little bit less than what we would consider really ideal, which is between 5 and 6. This breed's a pulled Hereford. Compared to Angus, they tend to be easier keepers, so they put on weight a little bit more easily. I can't really feel her ribs easy, but if I put some pressure, I can find the in between her ribs. When we palpate the ends of her short ribs here, she's very soft, very soft. So I can't feel the ends of any of those bones. If I push really hard, I can touch the ends of them, but for the most part, they're pretty well covered by fat. When we look at her hooks and her pins, they're very, very rounded. On that other cow, you could see they're kind of a little bit rounded, but they still had a shape to them. And here, they're just totally, totally smooth. Same thing on her backside here. They're actually covered by a big pocket of fat. And so around her tail head, she's actually got little rolls of fat here too. So she's in a good body condition. Looking at her just like this, I would probably call her a 7 to an 8. In my opinion, she's still at an ideal spot for this time of year. A little bit heavier than I would like to, but in a herd of mixed breed animals, you're gonna have to have some Herefords that are gonna tend to be a little bit more overweight just because they're breeding. Does that kind of make sense? Because we have to feed the Angus a little bit more to maintain the same body condition as we would the Herefords. So these are both pulled Herefords, and they're both on the upper end of the body condition score. And if these cows, as you look at them compared to other herd mates, they're obviously significantly bigger. They have a lot more fat cover. When we're looking at them here from just 10 feet away, I really can't see much or any differentiation of her ribs, both her ribs that are on her side and then those short ribs that kind of poke out. And maybe we can see a hint of one or two ribs on this cow if we imagine it a little bit. When we look at her hooks and her pins, the two points of her pelvis, you almost can't see them. On the front, you can kind of see a little bit of that protruding, but obviously you don't see the bone at all. You just see a little mound. There's literally hundreds of ways to manage body condition score and nutrition in beef cows. And some animals adapt better than others do. And so that's why a neighbor down the road can be doing something totally different that works. And you are doing something totally different at your place that also works.